Most people really don't understand what it is, but that doesn't stop them from getting it. I'm talking about the flu. And here to tell me more are Eddie Horner and Brent Dierking from North Star Emergency Medical Services. Guys, thanks so much for being with us today.
Thank you, Danny.
Absolutely. Well, it's that time of year, and I don't know about where you guys work yet, but here at WVUA-TV, we've had several people that are getting sick. They've got the flu, or they think they've got the flu, or something similar to it. Who gets the flu?
Well, it's that time of the year, you know, and this is one of those times that we really want to help educate everyone about their potential for getting some type of respiratory illness and or the flu. You know, we oftentimes see it in the very young and the elderly, especially over the age group of about 65. So it's real important that we spend time and just keep reiterating the message. It's important to understand that you're susceptible to the flu and that it's time to get a flu shot.
All right, super. Well, I'm glad to bring up flu shots because you hear all sorts of things. Get one, don't get one. What's your professional opinion?
Definitely get one. Anyone between the ages of 6 months to 18 years for children, the elderly, 65 and older, pregnant women, or anybody in the healthcare profession needs to get a flu shot.
So if you're going to be around sick people, or you
Definitely.
Teach school, or you're like me, you're here, you have people coming to you all the time, then you need a flu shot.
Definitely.
Exposure rate's
That's
pretty
right.
high. But what about this mist? Is that good? Is that better than a flu shot? Or
It's mainly a personal preference. Kids, they don't like shots, so generally they want the mist. And it seems to work about the same.
Oh, okay. Super. So, and that is the mist something you do daily, or is it a one-time thing?
It's a one-time thing.
Oh, okay. Wow. I bet the kids do like that. Now, the flu's contagious, right or wrong?
Definitely.
Wow.
It is contagious,
okay.
and you know, again, that's one of the reasons why we really want to present the message, because if you start feeling sick, you know, you get a sudden onset of fever, runny nose, those things that you typically think to yourself that, hey, I'm achy, mm-hmm. and I'm thinking that I'm getting the flu, you know, you don't really need to be going around people, because the last thing you want to do is pass that on to someone else. So if you start feeling like you're having signs and symptoms of the flu, it's important that you reach out to your primary care physician and try to get advice from them as to what they would like to do and what course of action that they would like to take. A lot of people want to go immediately to the emergency room.
Right.
We don't recommend that. You know, the emergency department is for emergencies. So certainly if you're having a life-threatening situation, you need to dial 911 and access the EMS system. But reach out to your primary care physician if you're having those symptoms. And let's see if they can give you some guidance on what to do.
All right. We're out of time, but let's squeeze this in real quick because I know it's important. How do we keep from catching it?
Basic hygiene. If you cough, cover your mouth. You know, if you sneeze, cover your mouth. Wash your hands as often as possible. So if you just basically take those simple approaches to good hygiene, you're going to reduce your likelihood of getting and or spreading the flu.
All right, super. Guys, thank you very much for being with us today. Solid advice. Probably saved me from getting sick. If you are sick, stay away from here. You can find out more about North Star EMS by calling 205-970-8674. Learn more online at northstar-ems.com.